Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's glad to see you for coming today. We are from English Language Education. We would like to give you about how to deliver an effective group presentations. So my name is Karek Isadiswendra.
And my name is Dagita Pranyawati.
My name is Noel Rajasthi Prabhusati.
My name is Nikomana Dutahayu.
And my name is Noel Asimudhu.
So the first presenter is me, and for the other, please sit down. So let's start with the overview of our presentations. So as you can see, there are 10 points that are important in our presentations. The first is prepare for your papers. The second is time yourself carefully, practice diligently, fake confidence, show your emotion, speak to your audience, mind your body language, consider your audience, think of your presentation as a story, make your slides are visual or possible. So let's start with the first point. It is prepare for papers. So prepare for papers. Getting nervous is commonly in when you do a presentation. So it is about a small problem in presentations, but it will affect to your performance when you do a presentation in front of an audience. So the most important things you do when you do a presentation is prepare yourself before you do a presentation to prevent to getting nervous. So I have three steps you can follow. The first is you can write down in a paper or just think in your mind about something that maybe get you nervous when you do presentations, or something that you get afraid from your presentations. For example, looking foolish, there is a problem with your breath, or being afraid about a question from the audience. So you have to find the solution before you do presentations. So the next part is time yourself carefully. So the time is very important when you do a presentation. So you have to manage it carefully. You can practice before you do presentation. Take a stopwatch and manage your time. When you, for example, when you get 5 minutes for the presentation, at least you manage your time 4 minutes. So the next presentation, it will be delivered with my friends in town.
Okay, thank you, Krishna. So, before you already learn and you already hear about Krishna's presentations about
time yourself carefully.
So next, we will learn about practice repetitively. So, practicing is very important because by practicing, you will know how does it feel when you will do your presentation. So, practicing, it will make you less nervous and it will make you more prepared. And actually by practicing, you can make yourself more ready with your presentation. You can do practice by standing in the mirror and do your presentation or in front of your parents or friends or even pets. And you can also do practice by recording yourself so you will know how you will sound and how you will look at your presentation. Take notes and you will know how you will sound and your gesture in your presentation. So you will know what to practice more so your presentation will be more better. And you can also do practice by reading your script out loud. Don't just read it silently, read it out loud, because by reading it out loud, you will know how you will sound at your presentation. So if your sound is a little bit small, you can follow up your sound so it will be more powerful and your audience can hear your voice. And the next, point is we will talk about how to deliver a presentation in confidence. So the first thing that you can do to deliver your presentation with confidence is fake your confidence. I know that having confidence is very difficult, but actually you can fake it. So by faking your confidence, you'll feel confidence itself. So stand up straight and then chin up, smile, and do eye contact to your audience. And after that, you will feel more confidence. And before you go to your stage, you can also take a deep breath and exhale it, so you will feel more relaxed. And later, you will get the confidence yourself. And the next presentation will be presented by Pasha. So thank you. Pasha, please.
Okay, thank you, Kimban. The next point is show your emotion. Emotion is very important when you're doing presentation. Your face is watched whenever you speak in front of the audience. So you must smile, raise your eyebrow, and otherwise tell your story about your feeling as well as fact. So if you don't smile with your audience, and the audience probably see you as a serious person, and the audience will curtail you, and the audience can doing your presentation, and the audience not to participate in your audience. So you must smile with your audience. A good smile will put yourself and your audience at ease. So there are many kinds of emotion that will use in your presentation. The first is smile. Smile means happy or happiness, and frowns, it means unhappy or anger. And the third is snares, it means you dislike. And the last is putting your lips, it means sad. So the next point is speak to your audience. So when you're preparing the presentation, what will you know about your audience? So the first is you must know what is the size of your audience, and then the second is you must know how do you provide your audience, or how do you motivate your audience, and then the third is how do you know about the attitude of your audience. So speak to your audience is fun and exciting. So you must see your audience directly, because when you see the audience directly, and the audience will feel happy, or the audience will feel you motivate your audience. Okay, that's all about my material, and the next material will be continue with Amira.
Okay, thank you very much. Yeah, I already tell to you the important point how to deliver an effective presentation. So now my name is Ari. I would like to continue the presentation. I would like to show 2 points here. The first is about mind your body language. Body language is really important in your presentation. The first thing that you should consider in body language is your facial expression. Facial expressions is conveys your communications, and also it conveys the information that you want to share to your audience. If you want to share to your audience, take for example the terrible event, you may show that you are sad, but in fact, your face expression is happy that make the audience feel confused with your presentation. And your facial expression is really important. Your eyes, your eyebrow, and also your mouth is really important in showing your fear, your sadness, angry, nervous, confident, and etc. If you want to show to your audience that you are happy, you may smile to your audience. And if you want to show that you are surprised, you may wink your eyes. And if you sad, you may lower your eyebrow. And then the second point here is about body movement. But body movement is very important to make your presentations more effective and to make your audience understand about what you are going to say in your presentation. The first thing that you need to consider is don't just keep your movement just like that. So you need to move to the stage, or you need to interact with your audience, because the stage is yours, so you don't need to think about your nervousness, because this stage is already yours. And then the second, yes, don't act this body movement. This called a half hand. And if you act just like this, it show that you are not confident, and it makes your audience will feel bored, and also you will lose your audience interest. So now let's move to the second point. Here is about consider your audience. You need to consider your audience before you doing a presentation, because consider your audience is really important to design a material that's appropriate to your audience. If your audience is the expert one, you may create your materials as specific as possible, because the audience is expert and already know the general idea about your presentation, so you need to put the specific information in order to enrich the information of your audience. And then the second is you need to consider the size of your audience, whether it's small or big audience. If your audience are small enough, you can't create a material that allows you to interact with your audience, and maybe you can question in your audience and also doing a conversation with your audience. So I think that's all about body language and to consider your audience in order to deliver an effective presentation. So the next is, there are still different important points that you need to know in order to make a good presentation. The other point will be delivered by my friend, Monica.
Okay, so thank you, Ari. And now, I will continue the presentation. Let me explain to you the last two points of our presentation today. So the first one is, think of your presentation as a story. It may be easier to you when you explain to your audience about your material as a story. And also it may be easier to your audience to understand about your material. Instead of organizing your presentation by many topics and subtopics, it will be more effective if you presenting your material like doing a storytelling. Because when you do a storytelling, you put your audience into a situation. Start your presentation by setting the stage, then you pull your audience into the material by exciting climax. And it is may help you when you start your presentation by asking a question. And your audience may feel involved in your presentation from the beginning of your presentation. And to be an effective presenter, you have to consider the scope of your material. You have to lead yourself and your audience into the main point, because some of the presenters may talk too much and it is not related with the main point. So you have to lead yourself and your audience. And let's jump to the last point of our presentation today. It is about make your slide art visual as possible. When you do a presentation using a PowerPoint, it may help you a lot, because when accidentally you forget about your material, you can see your slide. It may help you. You can put the main point of your presentation on the slide. But when you use a PowerPoint, you have to consider a lot of things, like the background, the slide, the font of your slide, and you have to make your slide up visual, because it is really important to your audience to understand about your material, and it makes your audience interest in your presentation. And to be an effective presenter, you have to avoid many bullet points in your slide that explain anything that you are going to say. It will be better if you put a chart, photos, or illustration on your slide. This way, it can make your audience put their attention or their focus on you, and they will get the point of your presentation. So, I think that's all about our presentation today. The next section will be handled by Krishna.
Okay, thank you, Vipo. So, I think all presenters have already presented about materials. And is there any questions about the presentations? No, because there is no presentations. I would like to say thank you for giving your attention during the presentations, and thank you again for coming for today, and have a nice day. See you. Cheers.